Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for this opportunity. I would like to present my paper about prostatic hyperplasia. The title is The Effect of Tamsulosin and Dutasteride Combination Drug Therapy on Prostate Volume in Patients with Benign Prostatic Hyperplasia. It was conducted by me, myself, Dr. Pandu Ishak Mandana, urologist. I was get help from my college student, Lalu Rizky Adipura, and supervised by my teacher, Professor Hairani Rashid, internist. First, background. Benign prostatic hyperplasia, or BPH, is a condition when the stromal and epithelial cells that forming the prostate glands experiencing a benign enlargement. The incident and prevalence, there is still no exact number, but it tend to increase with age. Data from the Rumah Sakit Cipto Mangunkusumo from 1994 to 2013 shows a total number of 3,804 cases with mean age 66.61 years old. The symptoms of this BPH, we usually call with LUTS, lower urinary tract symptoms, is nocturia. It was voiding during nighttime more than two times. There is incomplete voiding or terminal dribbling. There is abdominal straining. You have to strain to start the void process. Intermittency and frequency. You have to go to the bathroom more than seven times a day. Weak stream, and sometimes dysuria or pain while voiding. This is the prostate. You can see this is the bladder, and this is the prostate. This is the urethra, and this is when you have a BPH, the urethra is narrow, so it's obstruct the urine to come out from the bladder. Diagnosis, we have to do anamnesis and history taking, because this is a chronic process, so it goes slow and getting worse during time. The IPSS, or International Prostatic Symptom Score, this is to make easy your anamnesis. Physical examination and supporting examination. In this study, we use a measurement of the prostate by ultrasonography. We use abdominal ultrasonography. This is the ultrasonography for the prostate. This is the bladder, and this is the prostate. This is the diameter of the prostate. This is the bladder, and this is the prostate. Longitudinal and transversal. Therapy. The drug used for BPH, there is two group. First one is alpha adrenergic antagonist. We use in this study is tamsulosin. It works by inhibits the contraction of prostate, smooth muscle, and the bladder neck. It has a rapid onset, so just few days and your symptoms will relieve. And the second group was alpha reductase, 5-alpha reductase inhibitor, or dutasteride. It inhibits the conversion of testosterone to its active form, dehydrotestosterone. It works to prevent the hyperplasia process, so it can reduce the size of the prostate, but it has a slow onset, maybe 1 to 3 months. This is the works of the pharmacology. This is the bladder. This is the alpha blocker. It relax the bladder muscle. Bladder neck muscle, and relax the prostatic muscle, smooth muscle. The 5-alpha reductase inhibitor is, the effect is in the prostate gland to reduce the size, so it can arrest the disease process. Methods. First, we use a comparative numerical analytical research model, cross-sectional type. The data obtained by documenting the medical records. The sample chosen using consecutive sampling technique, so all patients included in this study. All patients with prostate symptoms are included in this study. And confirmation diagnosis using by abdominal ultrasound for prostate volume. There is 20 new BPH patients and never receive any BPH therapy. They have no history of prostate cancer. This is the inclusion and exclusion criteria. The variables are age, prostate volume before and prostate volume after the therapy. The result, first, the age distribution, you can see that there is 85% of patient is more than 60 years old. 17 patient with age more than 60 years old. The pre-therapy age, the distribution, mean age is 67.4 years. The oldest is 77 years old, and the youngest is 56 years old. Volume prostate pre-therapy, there is an even number, 50% and 50% for the prostate, more and less than 40 centimeter cubic. Distribution of prostate volume pre-therapy, the average volume is 51.71 cc centimeter cubic, and the largest volume is 118, and the smallest volume is 25. After the therapy, there are increase of the number of the prostate less than 40 centimeter cubic. It's 60% of the patient has a prostate less than 40 centimeter cubic. This is the distribution of the mean volume is 42.38. It's reduced. The largest volume are 92 centimeter cubic and the smallest are 22. With the comparative hypothesis test, comparison of age and the decrease of the prostate volume post therapy with unpaired T test, there is no significant difference. But the comparison pre-therapy and post-therapy prostate volume with PRT test, there is a significant difference. With the correlative hypothesis test, with linear regression, for pre-therapy and post-therapy prostate volume, there is a strong relationship. This is the discussion. In our study, the sample age is more than 60 years and with no significant difference between age and prostate volume. But the other study shows that the average age is less than 60 years old. The Chung Tai et al. In 2016, from 278 male patients, whereas the average age are 58. And Simonson et al. In 1987, there is a significant relationship between age and prostate volume. But some are consistent with our finding. From our study, there is the combination therapy shows significant difference on pre and post therapy of prostate cancer. The others say the same. Ruhrborn at 2008 from 4,844 men with BPH receiving 2 years combination therapy have a decrease of prostate volume and relieve the lower urinary tract symptoms better than patient that not complete the course. And our study shows that Dutasteride gave significant result on decreasing the prostate volume. It also said with Nickel et al. In 2001, it says the same. And Zhu et al. In 2019 shows that Dutasteride has a better effect compared to other drugs with the same class from 5-alpha reductase inhibitor like finasteride and with smaller dose. The conclusion is there are a significant difference in prostate volume reduction in BPH patient treated using a combination drugs of tamsulosin and dutasteride at RSUD Kota Mataram. I think that's all. Thank you for your kind attention.